Okay, students, so we have seen the various properties of the plastic. It is deformable, good corrosion resistance, it is resist to the chemical actions, it is smooth and rigid, it is having weather ability, it is having color ability, heat resistant, deformability. What are the applications that we have also seen? The plastic is applicable in automotive vehicles, in automobile industry, aircraft industry, electrical applications, communication industry, household goods, artificial gifts. That we have seen, plastic is we used everywhere. Okay, so here is some examples of the plastics. Okay, now what are the types of plastic? There are generally three types of plastics. Plastics are categorized into three categories. One is thermoplastic, thermosetting plastic, and elastomers. The first we will see the thermoplastic. Thermoplastic, these are the materials, those which soften on heating and can be set into desired shape by cooling. Also known as thermosoftening plastic. This thermoplastic is also known as thermosoftening plastic. These don't undergo chemical changes when heated and softened by heating. It can be reshaped. Okay, the thermoplastic is the only plastic which can be remolded, reshaped again and again. These the scrap can be reused again and again. They can be remelted again and again. So the best examples of thermoplastics are acrylics, nylon, PVC, polyvinyl chloride, polystyrene, ABS. Its full form of ABS is acrylobutadiene styrene. Okay, so these are the examples of the thermoplastic. The second one is polyethylene. We will see the examples of thermoplastic materials. Polyethylene. Polyethylene, we can say PE. Generally polyethylene. But in general use we say polyethylene. Okay, so what are the characteristics of polyethylene? It is one of the lightest plastic. Generally we use the plastic which is very light in weight. It is unaffected by foods stuff. It is tough and flexible. It has high electrical resistivity. It is very cheap. It is cheaply available in the market. It has low coefficient of friction. It has low strength and cannot absorb moisture. What are the examples of the polyethylene? These polyethylenes are used generally in a grocery shop. We can say by plastic bags, tubes, containers, battery parts, ice tray, packaging material, electrical insulation, milk and water bottles. These bottles are also made up of polyethylene. Okay, Bisleri water bottle, that bottle is also made up of polyethylene. Okay, polyvinyl chloride, the second is PVC. Generally we see the ads PVC pipes, polyvinyl chloride. What are the properties of the polyvinyl chloride? It is from the category of the plastics called as vinyls. Okay, it is having very low cost and most widely used. This PVC is most widely used in farming for the pipes, or in a construction industry to supply the water. These PVC pipes are generally used. Made up from the HCl acid, limestone and natural gas or coal. They have resistance to acids and alkalis. It is good toughness. It is having good toughness. It is having good strength. It is abrasive resistant. It is low moisture absorption capacity. It is having low moisture absorption capacity. Available in rigid and flexible types. Its applications are used generally in electrical cable covers, credit cards, car instrument panels, pipes, PVC pipes. Generally we see this is the polyvinyl chloride. Third example of thermoplastic are acrylonitrile butadiene styrene, that is generally ABS. It contains acrylonitrile butadiene styrene and styrene monomers in varying proportions. What are the properties of ABS? Properties: general, it is resistant to the fracture by impact. It is having high tensile strength. It is having high abrasive resistance, can resist the attacks. Resistance to acids and alkalis. It is available in the form of molding powders for the use in the injection molding and extrusions. Applications in automobile industry for panel work. ABS is generally used in automobile industry for panel work. ABS can be chromium plated when used in radiator grills. It is generally used in TV cabinets, cameras, telephones, refrigerator liners. The fourth one is Teflon. Teflon tape is generally used it is made up of thermoplastic, PTFE. This is also called as PTFE, polytetrafluoroethylene. Polytetrafluoroethylene, that is shortly called as Teflon. It is type of thermoplastics called as fluorocarbons. Most important of these materials is polytetrafluoroethylene. It resists attacks by all solvents and chemicals. It can withstand over wide range of temperature than the other plastic materials. Excellent electrical insulators, lowest coefficient of friction. Applications, generally these applications are chemical pipes and walls, bearing bushes, frying pan handles, non-stick coatings. These are generally made up of Teflon. Fifth one is polyamides. This is PA. It is having the properties like can be molded. It can be molded. Obviously, it is a thermoplastic, so it can be molded. It can be extruded. It can be formed into desired shapes. It can be formed into sheets as well as thin films and can be casted easily. It is having low coefficient of friction, excellent heat resistance and toughness, resistance to abrasion and chemicals. It is very strong, tough and light in weight, poor resistance to hot water, alcohol and ultraviolet light. Good, it is having good moisture absorption capacity, but its cost is very high. It acts as a good insulation properties. Generally, the applications of polyamides are clothing, rope, manufacturing of films, bearings, gears, camshaft, we can say. Okay, comb, bags, chairs, just these plastic bags, plastic combs, plastic chairs. These are generally made up of polyamides, drawer slider, machine slider, bushing, handles and jackets for wire and cables, washers, jewelries. These are the applications of the polyamides. The fifth one is acrylics. The fifth part or the fifth example of thermoplastic is acrylics. Acrylics are a group of vinyl plastic, of which the most widely used is polymethylene methacrylate, PMMA. Acrylics are group of vinyl plastics, which is the most widely used in polymethyl methacrylate, that is PMMA. It is very hard and rigid material. It can be easily molded. Resistance to the sunlight, it can resist to the sunlight, weather, most chemicals, excellent toughness, clarity, and it is having very color ability. Applications: fiber optics, nail paints, contact lenses, transparent balls, drink glasses. These are the examples of the acrylics. Acrylics is generally used in paint, okay, contact lenses, transparent balls, drinking glasses. These are made up of acrylics. Now the second part is thermoplastic. Okay, thermoplastic, thermosetting plastic. Now first we have seen the thermoplastic, now second we see the thermosetting plastic. So thermosetting plastics are these are the materials which soften on heating but cannot be set into desired shape on the cooling. These are the materials which soften on heating but cannot be set into desired shape on cooling, as once the thermosetting plastic is set, it cannot be remolded, it cannot be reshaped, it cannot be reused. Once it is set, it cannot be reused. So that's why it is called as thermosetting plastic. Once it becomes hard by chemical changes on cooling, examples are epoxies, melamines, polyester resins, phenolic resins, etc. It is very good tensile, it is having very good tensile strength, good compressive strength, good machinability, and good chemical resistance. Okay, some of the examples are here: crystal clear epoxy resins, crystal clear epoxy hardening, okay, super glossy coating. Coat for the coating purposes, these thermosetting plastics are used generally. So now we will see the examples of thermosetting plastic. Once it is set, it cannot be remolded. Just remember this point. Now the first examples of melamine formaldehyde, MF, is the first example of the thermosetting plastic, melamine formaldehyde. The melamine formaldehyde, it is also known as amino resin. The one of the examples, we can say this question is asked in examination. The melamine formaldehyde is also known as A, B, C, D, there will be the four options. It is also known as amino resins. They are harder than any plastic and has more heat resistance. They have resistance to water. They absorb less moisture. They have good heat and stain resistance. It is very expensive. It is having excellent dielectric properties. What are the applications of melamine formaldehyde? The applications are household cups, saucers, baths, and different kitchen utensils. Domestic tableware, paints, plywood, glues, decorative laminates. Here are the examples of melamine formaldehyde. Now, the second example is polyesters. What are the properties of polyesters? It is low cost, easy handling, unlimited colorability, diamonds. It is having good dimensional stability. It is good electrical insulating properties, weather and light resistant. It is fire resistant, heat resistant. It is used for molding purposes. This resistance to the humidity, acids, greases, oils. What are the applications of polyesters? The polyesters are applicable in magnetic recording tape, clothing, automatic fire records, bottles, trays, helmets, fiberglass boards, chairs, fans, etc. Third example is epoxy resin. Epoxy resins are cross-linked plastic by addition of hardener. Okay, what are the properties of epoxy resins? They are the product of epichlorohydrin and polyhydroxy compound. It is referred as epoxy. It is good adhesion, sticking properties. It is excellent chemical resistance. It is having low moisture absorption. It is excellent dielectric properties. It is good heat resistance and corrosion resistance. It is also expensive. It is having dimensional stability. Epoxy resins, we can say. What are the applications of epoxy resins? Applications is, this is generally used in electrical molding, sink, kitchen utensils for washing, protective coating, painting, fiberglass laminates, aircraft, automobile industry, domestic applications. These are the examples of epoxy resins. silicones. What are the silicones? This is also the example of thermosetting plastic silicones. Properties: these are semi-organic compounds available as viscous oil, grease, plastic rubbers. Properties remain constant over a wide range of temperature. It is also expensive, water repellent, and low mechanical, but it is having low mechanical strength. Applications: silicones is generally applicable, widely used for waterproofing clothes, shoes, in the paint and coating also. Phenol formaldehyde bakelite, it is also called as phenolics. Phenol, the common question asked in examination, what is the chemical name of the phenolics? So it is phenol formaldehyde bakelite. Okay, oldest thermosetting plastic, phenol formaldehyde resin, also called as synthetic plastic. Properties: good, it is having good strength, rigidity, unaffected by water and oil, dimensionally stable, it is good heat resistant, it is having good dielectric characteristics, it is having low cost, limited colorability, compound with a large number of resins. What is the applications of phenol formaldehyde bakelite? It is generally used in motor housing, telephones, electrical parts, moldings, etc. Elastomers, a natural or synthetic polymers having elastic properties, example rubber. Okay, polymers having very high elasticity, highly deformable, has long flexible molecular chains, example rubber bands. So there are two types of rubbers. What is rubber? Elastomers, manje generally it is called as rubbers, natural or synthetic polymer. It is a natural rubber or synthetic rubber. It is rubber, and elastomers are of two types. One is natural rubber and second is synthetic rubber. First of all, we will see the natural rubber. Natural rubber, it is desired from the latex, a milky colloid produced by some plants. Natural rubber is often vulcanized. The process, there is one process called as vulcanization, in which a process by which a rubber is heated and sulfur and peroxide are added to improve the resistance and elasticity and to prevent it from the perishing. Long, it is having long fatigue life, it is having high strength, it is poor resistance to the oil and solvents. It is normally very stretchy and flexible and extremely waterproof. Applications: uses of rubber are door and window profiles, hoses, pipe hoses, belt drives, matting, flooring and dampers for the automobile industry. Gloves, hand gloves, we can say toy balloons are also large consumers of rubbers. Now, first, we see the natural rubber is polybutadiene rubber. Polybutadiene rubber is a polymer formed by the process of polymerization of the monomers called as butadiene. There is number of butadiene when combined together, that is called as polybutadiene. Poly means many and butadiene. Number of butadiene when combined together, it forms a polybutadiene. It is high resilience. It is having high resilience. It is a synthetic rubber, poor tensile and tear resistance. Because of this reason, it is blended with the other elastomers. It is having poor resistance to the chemicals and sunlight. It is having high good, has good low temperature properties. Applications: it is generally used for vehicle tires, blended with the NR for trucks and with the SBR for motor car tires. Styrene butadiene rubber, it is also one of the type of rubber. It is a synthetic rubber. It is a polymer formed from the polymerization of monomers called as styrene and butadiene. Styrene and butadiene when combined together, it forms the polymer that is called as styrene butadiene rubber. Okay, these are also called as Buna S. Okay, the question is asked in examination. Styrene butadiene rubber is also known as Buna S. It is excellent impact and abrasion resistance. The styrene butadiene ratio influences the properties of the polymer. With the high styrene content, the rubbers are harder and less rubbery. used widely in pneumatic tires. It is generally widely used in the pneumatic tires. Okay. Other uses include shoe, heels and soles, gaskets and even chewing gum. Acrylonitrile butadiene rubber. Okay, NBR, acrylonitrile butadiene rubber. It is a synthetic rubber. It is a polymer formed from the polymerization of the monomers acrylonitrile and butadiene. It is also called as Buna N. It is very expensive. See, styrene butadiene rubber is called as Buna S, and acrylobutadiene butadiene rubber is called as Buna N. It is expensive. It is having excellent resistance to the oil and fuels. It is majorly used for sealing applications like gaskets. It is also used for hoses, pipe hoses, we can say, conveyor belts and cables and washing machine parts. It is also used in making hand gloves. Okay. Now next is butyl rubber. It is IIR. It is also a synthetic rubber. It is polymer formed from the polymerization of the monomers called as isobutane and isoprene. Isobutane and isoprene, when combined together by the process of polymerization, when the number of monomers of isobutane and isopropane are come together by the process of polymerization, this form butyl rubber. Butyl rubber is produced by polymerization of about 98% of isobutylene. Here 98% of isobutylene is present and 2% isoprene only. It is cheaper than NR. It is having excellent resistance to ozone and aging, mainly used for tire inner tubes, inner liners of tubeless tires. It is used in hoses, chewing gum. Silicon rubber. It is a synthetic rubber. It is a polymer formed from polymerization of the monomers, silicon itself. Silicons are hydrocarbons. It is resistance to the heat. It is expensive. Can be worked at high temperature. It is resistance to some oil and liquids. Liquids is moderate, poor mechanical strength. It is used in vehicle tires, seals, belt conveyors, erasers, carpets, and gaskets. Other engineering materials, we can say in ceramics. One of the engineering materials called as ceramic. The name came from the Greek word called as keramos, and keramos means burn stuff. Keramons means burn stuff. Ceramics are inorganic non-metallic material. It is inorganic non-metallic material that are produced and used at high temperature. The examples of all types of glass products, including fiber, cement, limes, plasters, abrasive cutting tools, bricks also called as a ceramics, tiles, drain pipes, electrical insulators, dinnerware, sanitary wares, these are made up of the ceramics. Okay, so the classification of the ceramics are based on the production method. The ceramics are classified into the category three on the basis of production, on the basis of applications, and on the basis of crystal structure. Okay, so first of all, we see the based on the production method, natural ceramics, clay minerals, we can say silica, silicates, manufactured ceramics, aluminium oxide, silicon, nitride, borides, carbides. These are the classification of ceramics on the basis of production method. Classification of ceramics on the basis of applications: abrasive, fired, clay products, glasses, cements, refractories, insulators, pottery, and the other artwork. The ceramics are classified into basis of crystal structure. It is called as crystalline and amorphous. There are two types of structures called as crystalline and amorphous. Okay. So crystalline structure is general examples of MgO, Alu, Al2O3. Amorphous is glass. What are the properties of the ceramics? It is hard and brittle. Quickly broken. It can be broken quickly. Chemically inert. It is abrasive, resistance, It is corrosion resistant, it is heat resistant, it is good conductor, good electrical and thermal insulators, highly hard. Hardness is very hard. Hardness is very high and high melting point. It is chemical resistant. The second is a glass wool, made by the direct melting of the fiber glass wool, and provides excellent insulation for heat and cold. It is insulating material, glass wool, generally used for direct melting of fiber glass wool, and provide excellent insulation for the heat and cold. It is an insulating material made from the fiber of glass, arranged using a binder into a texture similar to the wool. Properties: it is formed in various diameters, can be used up to 500 degrees Celsius, may be bonded with the thermosetting resins, may be compressed to desired density, light in weight. It is very light in weight, can take any shape. It can be take any shape. Uses kute ahet? Glass, where, what are the uses of glass wool? It is used as insulator in exterior walls and in the ceiling of homes, buildings, in aeroplane, as a thermal and sound insulation. Domestic applications such as furnaces, oven, water heater, refrigerators and freezers. Glass wool boards and blocks are used to reduce loss of heat from the pipes, boilers, tanks, ducts. Air filters are made from the coarse wool to trap dust particles. For insulation of wire, cables and various parts of motor, generator, transformers. Composite material. The last one is composite material. What is a composite material? It is a material, it is defined as a material formed by the combination of two or more chemical materials, dissimilar materials with distinct boundaries between them. It is a material which is composed of at least two elements working together to produce material, properties that are different to the properties of those elements on their own. The base material is called as matrix and the other material is called as additive or reinforcing phase. Composite material made up of two, when the material is made up of more than two materials, it is called as composite materials. The composite material classification is as on the base, based on the arrangement of the reinforcement. Fiber composite, here we can see the examples of fiber reinforced composite. Okay, second one is particulate composite, flake composites and laminated composites. Laminates in the laminae. Okay, so this is the classification of the composite. Composite materials are classified on the base of the matrix, polymer matrix composite, PMC, we can say polymer matrix composite. It consists of fiber in a polymer resins matrix. It is also known as FRP, fiber reinforced polymer. It has good properties at room temperature. Commonly used fiber are glass FRP, automotive and marine bodies, lift springs, chairs, etc. Aramid FRP, pressure vessels, missile cases, clutch lining and gasket, etc. Carbon FRP, golf stick and fishing rods, aircraft, industry, helicopters, components, etc. What are the advantages? It is having high strength and stiffness. It is light in weight. The fibers act to block widening of any cracks, withstand at high temperature, corrosion resistance. It is design flexibility, can be molded into complex shapes. Metal matrix composite, MMC, it uses metals such as aluminium, magnesium, copper, tin, nickel as the matrix and reinforce it with the fiber such as graphite, alumina, boron, silicon. High strength and stiffness, high resistance to the fatigue, abrasion, wear. It is used in automotive connecting rods, pistons, aircraft, wings, panels, propellers of ships, turbines, blades, etc. Ceramic matrix composite, CMC. The fibers of one ceramic are reinforced into another ceramic matrix used in very high temperature environment. It is used in the furnace, gas turbines, and IC engines. Cirmets. It is a abbreviation for a ceramic and metal that is called as cirmets. When the it is composed of metal and ceramics, that is called as cirmets. Of ceramic and metallic materials, it is ideally designed to have the optimal properties of both ceramics and metals, such as high temperature resistance, high hardness, wear resistance, ability to undergo plastic deformation. Cirmets are usually less than 20% by the volume. Its applications used in manufacturing of resistors, capacitors, construction of vacuum tubes, use as a spacecraft shielding, as they resist the high velocity impacts of micro meteoroid and orbital debris. Okay, so thank you so much for joining.
Hello.